All right, let's get started.
Rolling.
Yeah.
That's what definitely.
There is a lot of hype about artificial intelligence today. That hype is well deserved. I think there are several places where investors and companies can find value with artificial intelligence. Most have been focused on the well-known large tech companies. I think in the future, there are going to be a lot more companies in a greater variety of fields that have proprietary or unique access to corporate data. So companies that you probably think of as being mature companies or not really AI companies will suddenly find that they have data assets that make them much more valuable because of artificial intelligence. There are differences by region in terms of how AI has progressed and developed. I think the US and China are probably the two countries where we've seen the most advances. And if you think about the environments in those two countries, there are different expectations, different norms around privacy in particular. And so in China, there's been an explosion of security and surveillance applications, taking advantage of the advances around computer vision and artificial intelligence. In the US, the advances in AI have really been concentrated amongst the biggest US tech companies. That has focused the use of AI around consumer use cases, and then we're at the very early stages of that being used for enterprise use cases. Whereas in China, there have been more startups that have really been able to get traction and succeed. And so you've seen actually more, I would argue, more commercialization of artificial intelligence in China. There are two trends in terms of M&A related to artificial intelligence. One is the acquisition of teams, essentially, where these larger tech companies are deciding, I need to get more AI scientists on board, not because there's a specific business there yet, but because we want that team to work on the things that we want them to work on. The other type of acquisition that's happening is centered around data assets. And we are seeing large companies look at both tech assets that you would consider artificial intelligence assets, as well as tech assets that you may not consider artificial intelligence assets, but because they have unique sets of data or unique data streams. What I would say is the value of AI is going to show up in surprising places. And where I would focus is actually on what you might consider mature companies that have the business processes and the data that's going to underlie the AI models of the future.